Welcome to the PHT Morning Skate, a collection of links from around the hockey world. Have a link you want to submit? Email us at pitblog@nbcsports.com. Despite not winning the Stanley Cup, the Vegas Golden Knights had an incredible inaugural season. Sportsnet, the Washington Capitals celebrated in style last night, as they racked up a $100,000 bill at their post-Stanley Cup party. TMZ, the Texas Stars beat the Toronto Marlies in Game 4 of the Calder Cup Final. This best-of-seven series is all tied up 2-2. Canadian press, the Capitals and their fans have gone through years of playoff heartbreak, but that finally all paid off on Thursday night. Washington Post, the city of Washington finally gets to celebrate a major sports championship thanks to Alex Ovechkin and his teammates. Sports Illustrated, not only did Lars Eller score the game-winning goal to clinch the cup for the Caps, he also became the first player born in Denmark to hoist the Stanley Cup. NHL.com, TJ Oshie got to share a Stanley Cup championship with his father, who's been dealing with Alzheimer's. What an emotional moment. ESN.ca, seeing the Capitals celebrate a championship victory at T-Mobile Arena wasn't exactly fun for the locals. Las Vegas Sun, it's been a great few hours for Alex Ovechkin. Not only because he's now a Stanley Cup champion, but also because he and his wife are expecting their first child. Russian machine never breaks, what does the Stanley Cup title mean to the fans in Washington? NBC Sports Washington breaks it down for us. NBC Sports Washington, up top, check out the highlights from the final game of the 2017-18 regular season. If you haven't figured it out by now, the Capitals won the Stanley Cup. Young fan Keelan Moxley remembers what it was like to get a puck from Caps forward Brett Connolly before Game 2 of Washington's first-round series against the Blue Jackets. Joey Alfieri is a writer for Pro Hockey Talk on NBC Sports. Drop him a line at pitblog@nbcsports.com or follow him on Twitter at Joey Alfieri. LAS Vegas, during Alex Ovechkin's first year in the NHL he was swimming at the house of Washington Capitals owner Ted Leonsis. As the boss and his newly drafted future superstar hung out, Leonsis told Ovechkin that one day they would be celebrating a Stanley Cup together. Ovechkin was still new to the league, didn't quite know the entire organization just yet, but he shared that dream with Leonsis. Little did they know it would take nearly 15 years from Ovechkin's draft day for it to finally become a reality. I knew he wants it so bad and this organization wants it so bad. It's nice to be part of it. Ovechkin said, it's nice to be in this organization, all 13 years or 14, whatever. It was a tough time, but we fight through it and we get results. Capitals end DC championship drought with first Stanley Cup win from 2007, when Ovechkin's Capitals first made the playoffs. Through 2017, they won 3 President's Trophies and 7 division titles. But the most important number was 0, as in the number of times they advanced beyond the second round. 6 times they were ousted by either the New York Rangers or Pittsburgh Penguins. Twice they blew 3-1 series leads. It became an inevitability, regular season success would lead to crushing playoff defeat. The lack of success and the burden to carry the Capitals to a championship would fall on Ovechkin's shoulders. He was the superstar. He was the one making the most money. Team's biggest rival, the Pittsburgh Penguins, won 3 cups since 2005-06, when Ovechkin and Sidney Crosby entered the league. As the expectation soared, the disappointments kept piling up until the season when many gave up hope of them ever winning. This was a different season, for sure. The Capitals cruised to another division title. Ovechkin scored 49 goals. But the pressure wasn't there entering the postseason. The Nashville Predators, Winnipeg Jets and even the surprising Vegas Golden Knights were the sexy picks out of the Western Conference, while some backed the Penguins for a three-peat or even the Tampa Bay Lightning. The only expectation some had with the Capitals was that they would fail again. When they fell behind 0-2 to the Columbus Blue Jackets in the first round, a familiar feeling was creeping in. But this team didn't wilt facing the task of regrouping and pulling off a comeback. Ovechkin, with help from Evgeny Kuznetsov, helped carry the team offensively and change a lot of narratives. I think there were a lot of series where maybe Washington got eliminated. Ovechkin had great series, said defenseman Brooks Orpik, who joined the Capitals from the Penguins in 2014. He probably took the brunt of the criticism just because he's the captain and the highest paid guy. I think a lot of guys feel for him in that situation. If you watched the reaction of his teammates when he got the cup, that speaks volumes about how guys feel about him. He's a very unique captain, probably never find a guy like him. But he's a guy who leads in a very unique way, but he definitely pulls guys into the fight. The desire to do everything possible to win was evident in every Ovechkin shift this postseason. When he wasn't scoring one of his 15 goals, he was playing a committed defensive game, even dropping down to block shots. Whatever it took. Every goal, even if it didn't come off his stick, resulted in a release of emotion never seen before, emotions that grew stronger and stronger as the win totals moved toward that special no. 16. When your captain is doing everything it takes, guys follow the leader. He's not the only one, said defenseman John Carlson. There's plenty of others that have stepped up and done amazing things at big points in time. But when your leader does those things, it gives a huge morale boost to the rest of us and we all want to win for each other. It's a huge statement by him. This is one of his better years that he's played overall, said Capitals general manager Brian McClellan. I think he's played a better team game the whole year. He's been more of a leader the whole year. You see him in the playoffs this year, he's our best player, blocking shots, playing good in the D-zone, playing good in the neutral zone. When he's doing them, it makes everyone else want to do them, too. Now the NHL story of Alex Ovechkin is now complete. He has a Conn Smythe trophy and a Stanley Cup to go along with his 3 Hart trophies, 3 Ted Lindsay awards and 7 Rocket Richard trophies. There's no more he's a great player, but to follow him around for the rest of his career, one that will see plenty of records shattered and maybe even another title. Ovechkin wanted this victory for himself and for his team. It's been a long road to get there and it showed each time he raised the cup over his head and showed off that big, toothless smile. Weight is off his shoulders. He's a Stanley Cup champion. It's even better. It's just like a dream, said Ovechkin. It was a hard, long season. We fight through it. We worked so hard through all the years and we were together. It was a whole one team, stick with the system and it doesn't matter what happened, even after the second period, we knew we just have to push it and get the result done. That's it. I can't explain the way I feel. It's unbelievable. Sean Leahy is a writer for Pro Hockey Talk on NBC Sports. Drop him a line at putblog@nbcsports.com or follow him on Twitter at Sean Leahy. As far as sports narratives go, there was plenty of magic surrounding both the Vegas Golden Knights and Washington Capitals' quests for a Stanley Cup. When it comes to suffering, the gulf couldn't be much bigger, as the Capitals have been waiting to win it all since 1974. During this Golden Knights run, fans of unsuccessful teams griped about the expansion draft, the bounces that went Vegas' way, and sometimes even flat-out admitted what the grumbling was truly about, envy. Now, finally, fans of all other 30 NHL teams can present them with some empathy. Some would probably say that June 7, 2018 is the true birth of Vegas Golden Knights fans. After all, do you truly understand the range of emotions a human experiences until you get your heart absolutely broken by the cruel whims of high-stakes hockey? The 4-1 series loss to Capitals featured interesting beats for fans who've experienced similar pain, even if such pain came much earlier in a given season. Your top line proves itself, only to sputter. An all-world goalie looks far too human. the opposing team's defense rarely gives you room to breathe, and all those things that worked from October to early April suddenly shrivel up into non-activity. Suddenly, the percentages go from friend to enemy. It all ended so swiftly and cruelly. Your team seemed poised to extend the series, with a late lead in the game, only to see a couple goals happen in a few minutes and before you knew it, it was all over. Fans, particularly those of teams who were juggernauts during the first 82 games of a season only to see it all crumble during a couple of weeks, are nodding their heads so hard at those notes. They're probably grimacing, too. After falling in Game 5, it seemed like every Golden Knights player could just copy and paste what head coach Gerard Gallant had to say about falling just 3 wins short of a championship. "We had an outstanding year, but it doesn't feel like it right now," Gallant said. "Obviously, we'll get to that in a few days' time. I didn't talk to the team after the game. They don't want to hear me after the game. They're disappointed and dejected, obviously. At some point, Golden Knights fans will feel great about this run again. They have the advantage of this being a truly unusual situation. Their first go at this exceeded any reasonable, honest expectation, likely even more than the most optimistic person in that organization. For all we know, this could be the best shot the Golden Knights ever get." That thought must dawn on at least some Golden Knights fans at the moment, mixing the disbelief of making this far with the fear of the unknown, even if this loss stands as the first article of clothing for their playoff baggage. This is literally a Vegas Golden Knights fan first day of hockey heartbreak. "Welcome to the club, enjoy the cash bar. Signed, every fan of every other team." If you dig around on social media enough tonight, you'll probably witness people getting into sports misery contests. For the more welcoming among us, this is instead like comforting your child after they get dumped or rejected for the first time. With that in mind, let's imagine ourselves giving grumbling Golden Knights fans a little pep talk. "Yep, this hurts. Maybe it cuts the deepest when you truly feel that sting for the first time. And, no, it's never fun or easy, especially when that sweet victory seems so close. Even if your team becomes a dynasty, you'll probably end most seasons with a bitter taste in your mouth. Maybe the thought of staring down the abyss haunts you, but what fun would it be to quit, summer goal, get better at pep talks? Want to watch Game 5 in its entirety? Click here." More, Capitals break DC drought, win Stanley Cup. Ovechkin takes home Conn Smythe. James O'Brien is a writer for Pro Hockey Talk on NBC Sports. Drop him a line at pitblog@nbcsports.com or follow him on Twitter @CycleLikesEdens. LAS Vegas, Barry Trotz sat at the podium in the bowels of T-Mobile Arena as the Washington Capitals continued celebrating their first Stanley Cup title in franchise history. He was relaxed and hydrating with a bottle of water, something he'd regularly remind the media to do at the end of each of his press conferences. "He was a man without a worry, and rightly so, having finally won a cup after 19 seasons of coaching in the NHL. Trotz said he was in a good place, personally. He entered the 2017-18 season without a contract beyond July 1st and now celebrates a championship with unknown future. But according to Capitals general manager Brian McClellan, that decision is entirely up to the head coach at this point. He's under contract until July 1st. He just won a Stanley Cup. So if he wants to be back, he'll be back," McClellan said after the Capitals' 4-3 cup clinching victory over the Vegas Golden Knights Thursday night. Capitals end DC championship drought with first Stanley Cup win. There's only one head coach vacancy in the NHL now that the New York Islanders have moved on from Doug Weight, but Trotz has more important things on his mind at the moment. "I said to Brian, there's no reason that I don't want to be there. No matter what happens, give me a couple of days to enjoy or not enjoy what happens," Trotz said. "But these are my kids. This is a pretty special group. We'll talk. I'm not worried, one way or the other. I've been doing this for a long time. I don't lose any sleep over it. McClellan likely used the playoffs as a gauge for deciding whether to offer Trotz an extension. Had they failed to come back against the Columbus Blue Jackets in the first round or fell once again to the Pittsburgh Penguins in the conference semifinal, it may have been easier to part ways. But despite trailing in every series, the Capitals recovered and are now champions. Now it seems that what once was an iffy situation has been given a little clarity. Winning does that. Trotz still believes he has a future in Washington. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, he said. Sean Leahy is a writer for Pro Hockey Tack on NBC Sports. Drop him a line at pitblog@nbcsports.com or follow him on Twitter at Sean Leahy. Sometimes a Stanley Cup celebration is about all-out elation, as you could see in Alex Ovechkin turning into a kid at a candy store after the Washington Capitals won it all. As you can see during TJ Oshie's interview with Jeremy Roenick, these championship runs often mix tragedy with triumph. Oshie was clearly emotional as he spoke of his father, who is struggling with Alzheimer's. One will stick with him forever, Oshie said of his father. TSN's Frank Saravalli captured a moment they had together after the interview. Check out highlights of the Capitals' 4-3 win against the Vegas Golden Knights in the Cup clinching Game 5. You can also check out the recap at this spot and replay the contest in its entirety here. This post takes a look at Alex Ovechkin's Conn Smythe victory. James O'Brien is a writer for Pro Hockey Talk on NBC Sports. Drop him a line at pitblog@nbcsports.com or follow him on Twitter @cyclelikesettings.